Hi everyone, welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emanuelle Kadosh, and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases, so don't forget to subscribe. Today, we brought an example of a denture. You can see the metal crowns in the frontal area is also made from metal because this patient has power of function. In this case, it's bruxisms. So the patient wears off his denture all the time, and the acrylic teeth just get smaller and smaller and wear off from this denture. So we constantly need to add acrylic teeth onto the denture. Now, the metal doesn't wear off as fast as the acrylic parts, and it holds the denture together. The main problem in these cases for the patient is not only that the acrylic and the dentures and all the restoration wears off, but there's a large amount of stress on the implants, on the screws, and all of the prosthetic parts that are on the implants. For example, the multi-units or the abutments, the prosthetic screws, and at the end, the implant themselves. Now, the main problem with bruxism is that you can break the implants. They can break the prosthetics. Ideally, the prosthetic parts would break instead of the implant themselves because the implant is the most problematic part to change. It's almost impossible to change the implant. You need to take out the implant with the bone and everything, and then there's bone augmentation. So in this case, first of all, when the implant breaks, it breaks around the neck of the implant or the platform of the implant where it's the thinnest. And when you have a crack or the implant breaks in this area, you can't use the implant. The crack can go forward and then you'll have bone respiration and you'll have a lot of problems with this crack. Now, the prosthetic parts can also break in the area of the multi-unit or the abutment and in the area of the screw that connects the abutment to the implant or the restoration to the multi-unit. So we prefer that the weakest part would be part of the prosthetic because then we'll know that the failure point will be the prosthetics and not the implant. In this case, you can see that the prosthetic that's in here is two pieces. It just broke down in half. Here you can see the screw is still inside, and here there is no screw. It's made out of titanium. So you put a lot of pressure and a lot of stress on the screws because the screw is the highest connection in the assembly of the implant abutment. Because the screw is the highest connection in the assembly of the implant abutment restoration, most of the pressure goes on this screw. So there is quite a high possibility that the thing that will break first is the screw itself. Screw-retained restoration is considered easy to fix. However, you have the same screw in the cemented restoration. In cemented restoration, you have prosthetic screws that connect the abutment to the implant. If you have a bridge and one of the screws breaks down and you need to take the bridge out, you need first of all to disconnect the bridge from the abutments. This is because you've cemented them in the middle, in between them, and that connects the restoration with the abutments. And because you need to cement this restoration, it's problematic because you need to apply force. And some of its screws broke down and all of the force goes on the screws that are left, which means you could potentially break the bridge or break the rest of the screws, or you can break the thread inside of the implant. So in screw retained restoration, it can be said that it's more comfortable to fix these problems. It's much easier because if you know that one of the screws broke down, you could take off the restoration. You can change the screw, you could take out the screw the same as you take out the cemented restoration, the same as you take out every broken screw in the assembly that you have. If the implant is holding and the screw is fine, you can take ultrasonic tip and with the vibration slowly take out the screw. You can have breakage in every connection. First of all, you have the implant. The implant can break down. Then on the implant, if you're doing screw retained restoration, you have a multi-unit. The multi-unit can break down. If the multi-unit breaks down, it breaks in between the connection to the implant and the screw of the multi-unit. So you still have some kind of screw in the implant left. And the second part is breaking the prosthetics through the screw that connects the restoration to the multi-unit. And if neither of them break down, you can break the crown. You can break it if it's PFM and you can break the porcelain on the metal. If it's zirconia, you can break the bridge. It depends on what is your weakest link, and you always prefer that it wouldn't be the implant. Here we can see what can happen if the implant were to break down. We can see that in this case, the thing that broke down is the prosthetic screw, and you can see the bridge separately from the screws. Next, we'll see the multi-units. Here you can see a very large magnification. You can see the parts of the screw that's left inside the multi-unit, and you can see the thread inside. So this is what happens when the screw breaks down. We have the restoration, we have the screw, We have the head of the screw with the cap inside of the restoration, and inside the multi-unit, we have the screw itself. Removing the screw from the multi-unit sometimes can be problematic. If you can't remove the screw from the multi-unit, the only thing that you can do is change the multi-unit to a new one. So in this case, it's always better if you're using original multi-units that you can use and you know that you have the same height as the multi-unit. Don't switch between companies from different multi-units. Our multi-units have the same height, so if some kind of failure occurred, you can take out the multi-unit, change to another one, which would be the same multi-unit, and just assemble back the bridge. Just connect the bridge back, because in this case, you have two parallel implants, and you know that an anterior and posterior movements apply a lot of pressure. You can see in the previous slide that the height crown is quite large. You have a little bit of bone loss, you have a little bit of gingival recession, and you have very high crowns. So a lot of pressure is applied on the crowns, and you have some kind of lever because of the crowns. You have them the moment they go onto the prosthetic screws. So there's really nothing to do in this case. You have the patient with bruxism, you have a very high crown. You really can't escape the situation in this case because you'll always have quite high pressure on the prosthetic parts. Now, choosing the correct restoration. If you know that the patient's condition is kind of like insurance, because if you know that it's on screw retained, it's easier to take out the bridge for any fixing that you need to do in the future or any changes. However, in cement restoration, you might need to take the entire bridge out and do the cementation, all this procedure all over again. So in cement restoration, it will be more difficult to fix this kind of problem. Now, with screw retained restoration, when you use TI bases for bridges, for example, in this case, you can take two TI bases, you can connect them to the implant and connect the cement to those TI bases. These crowns, for example, the weakest link will be the connection between the crowns and the implant. So it's unclear which one will break. The teeth won't just break, or you'll have breakage in the implant or the prosthetic screws. So when you're using multi-units, the weakest link will probably be the prosthetic screws over the multi-unit and not the implant, which is actually much better because you want to leave the multi-unit on hold. Maybe you can remove a little bit from the height of the crowns or do some kind of modification to the crowns so that there's not too much pressure on them, but you can't cure a patient with bruxism. It's not something that is treatable. Theoretically, we can try to have a monolithic zirconia. For example, if it's molars, we can make a crown for a metal which holds better because it's from one metal, so it won't break. If you have ceramic caps or metal caps, and on the metal, if you have porcelain on the metal, so the connection between the porcelain and the metal can break, so you can have a breakage of the porcelain. If it's molars, you can leave the whole crown just polished metal, like you saw on the denture that we showed you before. So we want to have crowns, and the material that suits best is monolithic zirconia or metal crowns, not PFM. People often wonder if gold is an option as well. It is, however, gold will cost a little more, and so in this case, we have our ways to deal with the situation, but you always have some compromise and some problems. The monolithic zirconia, you can't glaze, you can't do anything. You need to just polish it and leave it as is. The aesthetical part is not the most important part because you have the bruxism problem, so you're losing the functional problem. Either way, thank you all for joining to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you, and see you next time.